So as you all know over here, my name is Shahid, and I will be the one who will be conducting this particular training. So I've got an overall experience of almost 10 to 12 years professionally that I've been working, and I've been working with the CRM application for last 5 years now, and into the training industry as well. So before that, I was into the IT industry, and I have a little bit of a background into sales as well. I love what I do, and it is really good to impart the knowledge that we have. And these are some of the things that I have achieved in terms of my certifications and how we go about doing the trainings and everything. Okay, so this is it about me, short and sweet. Let's start with what we would be covering for today. So as you all would have already got the information out here that, you know, we are having a webinar for Power Apps with the CRM. Okay, now let me just give you a heads up over here. Now, Power Apps is based on a platform which is known as Power Platform. Okay, and Power Platform is a low code or a no code application. Then we have CRM. Okay, that's the customer relationship management application, which is built on Power Platform for us. Okay, and there we will even see how we will be able to have the integration options. Like if you are new to this particular platform, how are the integration options and will it suffice the need that you have? Okay, now before we get started over here, okay, let's understand and let's have an overview of what this Power Platform is all about. Okay, and I will be giving you a glimpse of your CRM as well. So before we get started with describing you with Power Platform, okay, let me give you an introduction of the CRM and how this Power Platform is actually built. Okay, so for that, I will be using the open board over here. So let me start with the introduction of this application. I'm using this open board over here so that, you know, it becomes a bit more interactive and for people who are just starting from the scratch would be able to relate to it. So we are talking about CRM, which is customer relationship management, which is also known as customer engagement applications. Now, basically, when we talk about these, okay, by the word itself, it talks about how we will be storing the customer's information. So normally, whenever we are working, we are actually working with all the data of our customers. So when we talk about CRM as a whole, okay, there are four important applications that is built on this particular CRM, wherein you will be able to manage the complete side of the business that you actually hold. Okay, so let me just give you an introduction of all these applications which are there. And then you yourself would be able to think that, okay, it covers almost everything that is there for any business that we are going to be running in or any business that we are operating in. It actually has all the capabilities. So the first application that we have over here is, which is customer insights or journeys, which earlier was known as the marketing application. Okay, now as the word marketing suggests, okay, what do we mean by marketing? Marketing is, it can be an advertisement. It can be an advertisement through social post. Right now we are in the era at the moment wherein, you know, we are very much familiar with the social media handles that we have. So whatever that you can do to create awareness about your product or service, you will be using this particular platform. Okay. So when we talk about this particular platform, what is the end goal of any of the marketing campaigns that you run in? It is to create awareness about the product or the service that we are offering and to create customers, right? We need to bring in the customers so that we will be able to sell them the product or the services. So here what we do is we generate leads, okay? Then we talk about the next step when we have the customers in hand with us. What is the next step that we need to do? We need to tell them about the features and the benefits of the product that we are actually, product or service that we are actually advertising them to, right? So in that case, there is this sales application, which comes into the picture, wherein we talk about the revenue, we talk about the goals, and we will be selling them the products or the services that we have to offer over there. Then, let's say, for example, you are done with all the information about the selling and everything. So do we think, or do as a customer ourselves also, because we are, if we are into the sales business, but we are still a customer of somebody, right? So whenever we, if we think it as a whole for us as well, being a customer, there is always a possibility that, you know, we need something that is after sales service. We are into the world wherein we actually need customer support to be at the best, right? That is where your third application comes into the picture, which is known as customer service. So customer service works with your service level agreements. It works with entitlements. Now, these are some of the terms that is being used in the CRM application. Okay. But then just to give you in a very natural language over here, it's basically post-sale services that you would be getting, and that services you will be able to do it remotely working. We are into the pattern of where we are working remotely. We will be able to give them the service remotely as well. And then the final application or the product that they have is field service application. As the word suggests, field service is mostly an on-site support that would require a physical intervention of any technician that needs to go and fix a particular product or the service that we are offering. Now, whenever you're going to be using this CRM application, you need to have a particular space or a particular storage area where you will be able to store all the information of your customer, right? That is where here we use something known as Dataverse, which is a storage platform that we have. So Dataverse is a data source for your CRM application, wherein you'll be able to store the information in the form of tables and columns. So when I say in the form of tables and columns, we can take a quick example over here that we have seen how the Excel worksheet works for us. Similarly, in that particular format, you'll be able to save the data. So it will become very easy for people to read it, to understand the information, what it actually means over here. Now we've talked about the data storage, or how, what is the data source that we have over here, and what are the applications. But now these applications are also built on a particular platform, right? You need somebody to be able to create this particular application, right? So that is where your Power Platform comes into the picture. What do we mean by Power Platform? Power Platform is a low code or a no code application. So what do we mean by this? Basically, let me tell you in a very easier way for you all to understand, okay? Right now, we have people from different backgrounds who are trying to attend to this particular webinar and trying to understand if there is a particular migration that we can do. Because let's say I have an experience of 10 years, right? And I've been into an IT industry wherein, you know, I've not worked on anything technical. So if I want to get into the CRM aspect of this particular application, it'll be a complete new turn for me, right? So is this a good career opportunity for me? So anybody who's thinking or who's having this particular question, okay, here with the help of your Power Platform, these things would be resolved for you, because this Power Platform is a low code or a no code application wherein you will be able to customize the application. You will be able to design the application. You will be able to create business rules. All these things you will be able to do by just a click of a button, by just, you know, doing a drag and drop, and you'll be able to completely customize this particular application. Now, see, I'm explaining it to you in a very natural language, thinking that we have people who are wanting to, you know, work in the CRM or maybe, you know about the application. But then in real also, it is as simple as this. But then again, it's more of the back end of the application, how these applications are created. Now, if you're using the CRM application, it is built on model-driven application, right? It is a model-driven app. And then there are different applications that we will be looking at that in the coming slides. So I've just given you an overview of what CRM applications are, what CRM is, what is their data source, and what is the platform they're actually working with. So let's get to understand more about these particular application. And if the time permits, what I would do is I will be able to give you a little bit of the demonstration of how this particular application works. What are the different components of this particular application? So I'm taking you back to the presentation over here. So now, as I've given you an idea of what this particular platform is, so right now when we see or when we read these things, it will make some sense to us to understand that what is Power Platform at the moment. So now Power Platform is a low code application that is for the development of this particular application. Now, what are the different types of applications that we have in our Power Platform? We have Power BI, right? Business intelligence. So you all might have actually heard about this tool, which is used to actually basically, you know, visualize or create reports or create dashboards, right? So you will be able to use Power BI. Then there is Power Apps development as well. What are the different types of applications that we have? We have a model-driven application. Now, CRM is a model-driven application that you work. I will be showing it to you how the CRM application looks like, okay? But it's a model-driven application. Then you have a Canvas application. Now, what do we mean by Canvas application? Canvas application, as the word suggests, it is through a blank canvas. So you will be able to create your own application the way that you want, how many pages that you want, what are the information that you want, what are the fields that you want, what are the tables that you want, what are the relationships that you want on that particular application is something that you will be able to work on it. Then there is something known as Power Automate Process Automation. Okay, so what do we mean by Power Automate? Now again, let me tell you this, this is just a webinar that where we will not be able to completely catch up with all these things. There would be only introductions that we can give you, but then Power BI itself is another course altogether, which has a course code of PL300. And when we talk about Power Platform, there is a different course for this, wherein we have PL900 that covers the fundamentals of Power Platform. Then there is PL200, PL400, and PL600 accordingly that it has. Okay, now here I'm just giving you an introduction so that if there are people who are using this particular application, it will be like a refresher. And what there's many a times wherein, you know, people have this information that they are actually working on the CRM application. Okay, but they do not have any idea what a Power Platform is. Okay, because they've never seen it, because they do not have the admin privileges. They do not log into the Power Platform admin center to know the customization. Maybe it would be that, you know, it is not their zone to be in because they have been given the application. They need to be the functional associate. So they are actually working on the application. But there might be people who would want to know what's happening behind the scene, right? Wherein we want to know how this particular application actually works. What are the customization? When we raise a particular ticket, it gets resolved. So who are the people who are resolving it? What takes them to resolve this particular aspect? So there is where your Power Platform comes into the picture. Okay, so I'm just giving you a gist of it so that, you know, we understand how these applications actually work in the background as well. There is where your Power Platform comes into the picture. We're talking about Power Automate over here. Now, what are Power Automate? Basically, Power Automate is an automation tool wherein you will be able to create flows. Okay, so when I say flows, okay, to give you a perfect example that we get, that, you know, let's say, for example, there is in an organization, there is a manager and he says that, you know, every day at about 5 o'clock, I need you all to send me a particular report, or, you know, like your daily report should be sent to me at about every day at 5 o'clock when you're going to be logging off. But now as a manager, he will not be able to write that email over and over again, like every day he has to type it in at 4:55 p.m. that, you know, please send me the report. Might as well, he can take the use, or he can make the use of this Power Automate process automation, wherein he will be creating a particular flow. Okay, and with the flow, he would have the subject, he will have the people, wherein at about 5 o'clock, there would be a reminder email that you get, and automatically people would be getting that email that, okay, it is time for us to basically send a particular report. Right. So these are some of the features. Now, there are a lot of flows that you can actually create. There are desktop flows that you can create. There are cloud flows. There are instant flows that you can create through your Power Automate. again, as I said, if we learn about this in detail, that's going to be another course altogether. And a lot of things are there. As an introduction part, I'm actually trying to explain it to you. Then we have Power Virtual Agents. Basically, Power Virtual Agents are the bots. So you will be able to create your bots. You will be able to train your bots. Okay. Now, if we have people working for CRM, or let's say, you know, we know the trend and everything. So there is an introduction of Copilot, right? So Copilot is basically what your Power Virtual Agents or the bots are, wherein they will be able to guide you. You'll be able to train them, and automatically they'll be able to resolve your issues. So you'll be able to train your bots in such a way that, you know, if there is any questions raised, it will be answered through your Power Virtual Agents. Then we have Power Pages as well. This is used for the external websites, wherein you'll be able to create a particular portal, and from there you'll be able to create the applications as well. We have different types of data connectors. Okay, it is built on a platform which is having a storage of data words, and it uses artificial intelligence builder as well, wherein you'll be able to use it. Again, as I'm saying, now for people who do not have any development background, or who do not have any, just to give you an idea over here, who are thinking maybe, you know, like this would be something difficult for us to go with. That is not the case over here, because these are simplified in such a way that, you know, anybody who was having basic idea of how the business works will also be able to upgrade themselves and learn about it. And trust me, Power Platform is really vast, and it is a very good tool to actually work with. Then we move on to our next, that is how we will be able to examine the application. So as I gave you an example of how, what are the CRM applications. So now if you see, there are these particular applications right now that is available. Earlier, there was also project operations. Okay. Though now it is used, but then it is used for people who are working with the projects. But then apart from that, you have, as I said, customer insights, which was earlier known as the marketing application. Now it has been shifted to customer insights or journeys. Similarly, we have sales hub application, we have field service, and we have customer service that is there in the engagement apps. And what are the engagement apps? The CRM engagement apps are, these are the things that we have over here. Then I've even explained it to you what Power Apps is and what it can actually do for you, right? So basically it's a low code or a low code platform for building the application, right? In natural language, in normal language, these are the platform wherein you will be able to customize, or you will be able to build the application. Now, what are the two types of applications that you can actually build, right? So the two types of application is Canvas app, which is built from a blank canvas, wherein everything, the borderline, the company logo, or anything that you want, you'll be able to create it through the Canvas application, which is built on your mobile or tablet devices that you can build. Now, let me give you a very good example over here. Whenever you have, you know, you order a particular food, right? You order a particular food. So you have a particular place or a portal where you actually order that particular food, right? Or you have some chat system as well. Similarly, these mobile applications that you have, so we are talking about those applications which you will be able to build from Power Apps. Okay. So now they might be thinking that, you know, how can I actually develop a particular application? But with the help of Power Apps, you'll be able to create your own application based on the creativity skills or based on the normal skills. And right now they have become so much easier with the introduction of the Copilot feature that is there in your CRM. So now CRM application helps us create the application in just about a click. So you give them the information in your natural language with the help of Copilot, you will be able to. So Copilot has basically made things very much easier for us. Then we have model-driven applications. What are model-driven applications? This is built from data in Microsoft Dataverse. I've explained what Dataverse is and how you will be able to create those particular application is, you'll be able to create it using data, Microsoft Dataverse, because CRM uses this particular data source over here. You'll be able to add the artificial intelligence to your app also with the help of no code. You'll be able to use the AI builder. Again, that is also something that
with the help of, with the introduction of your co-pilot, these things have also become much more easier. Now, basically, it will give you the predictive analysis of how you're doing. And, you know, there are a lot of things on the application as well, like it will be giving you the insights and everything based on the artificial intelligence or based on the information or the records that you create.
So we talked about this Canvas application. Okay.
As I said, Canvas application, we will be able to create this particular application from a blank canvas. You'll be able to start using it through the screen size. Okay. Is it going to be how will it be looking in a tablet or a mobile format? Okay. And what are the areas like whenever we are going to, and as I said earlier, you know, I gave you a very basic information about drag and drop. Though definitely when we learn about these, when we are working on it, we will be knowing it that, you know, it would be not that easy. Okay. But then again, you know, as you keep working on it, you know, when you know the business and everything, it will make things easier for you. But then again, as I'm saying, drag and drop are the various controls that you have. So whatever that you need, mostly you'll be able to drag and drop that information and that's it. And if you know basic Excel formulas also, you'll be able to create it from blank canvas. Okay. Then we talk about model-driven applications. Model-driven applications are built from a data in Microsoft Dataverse. Power Apps will build you a great looking or fully functional app. So basically, if you see this particular picture right in front of you, this is a model-driven application. This is a Power Apps wherein you will be able to create these particular applications. So in this particular application, what are the different types of tables that you want? What are the different types of fields that you want? What are the different types of areas that you want? All these things you will be able to customize. Now, let me tell you one thing. You will be able to customize this application because it's a highly customizable application. And one good thing is the out-of-the-box feature of this particular application is also designed in such a way that anyone who's using this particular application would not want to customize it. Okay, so now I am actually contradicting my statement itself that you're saying it's a highly customizable application. But why do you say that, you know, the out of the box? Because it has been designed in such a way that, you know, if there is a small scale business who are going to start or wanting to have the implementation of this particular application, they can use the out of the box features which are already there and also start the business that they are actually wanting to migrate from anywhere that you want to. Okay, because it will give you all the elements that is required. But let's say, for example, you as an organization would want to say, no, we want to customize it for the way that we want to. Let's say, you know, you're saying that we want to change the particular logo. We want to change the particular background. Maybe the language is something that we are not liking it. We would want to have it on it. The environments to create all these customizations and everything can be done through your Power Platform portal that we have. And that is, and these things can be customized from your make.powerapps.com from the PowerMaker portal, where you'll be able to customize the application. You will be able to build the tables. You'll be able to add tables. You can use the existing tables. You will be able to create relationships as well between the tables that you want to. There are some forms. You'll be able to create those forms as well. You'll be able to create business process flows. You'll be able to create business rules as well through this particular application. Now, for people who have an idea of the terms that I've used, will be able to understand. And if not, then, you know, we have a time constraint that, you know, I would not be able to explain it to you all. But then basically, it will actually help us in understanding the complete business life cycle over here, that, you know, how a particular application should work. Now, when we talk about this application over here, okay, so what are the different integration options that we have? So now, Shahid, you have said that, you know, it uses Dataverse as their data source. So it has its own data source environment that is there. So what are the different integration options that we have? Like, I have data in different data sources. I would want to have these integration options in your dynamic CRM. Only then there would be a change that I can actually bring about in my business. So to let you all know, that option is also available over here, when we will be able to use the external data sources also and get this
things in our applications. So basically, here they are talking about the integration options that we have. So when we talk about the integration options, let's first understand what are the different types of customers that we have and what are the different types of activities that we have. So customers definition, basically, we have B2B, that is customers are from the other businesses, or B2C, wherein we can directly associate with individuals. So either we are working with the organizations wherein we are dealing with if something is being outsourced to us, or directly with the consumers or with the individuals that we are working. You can use the hybrid model also, wherein you have customers who are who basically the organizations or the businesses are also your customers, and you also deal with the individuals as well. So those can also be your customers. So basically in your Dynamics 365, it supports all three business models over here. Okay, so B2B, B2C and the hybrid, if you want to use both together, you'll be able to use all these things as well in your Dynamics CRM application that is there for us. So now is talking about the activities. Okay, so basically if you have used this application, you will be able to create activities. And why do we create activity? Now when I say about the activities, what are the activities that we are talking about? Now this again is a term that is used in the Dynamics CRM application. Okay, so let's say for example there is a sales call that needs to be made, right? So here you can have a phone call activity, or let's say you have a sales meeting. So there is an appointment that you want to actually create. So you'll be able to create those activities for any particular customer. Okay. And when it is going to be due, it will be giving you the notifications. You can have, there is an introduction of the dialer as well in CRM at the moment, wherein you will be able to directly call that particular customer. Okay, and deal with them, or if there is any email that needs to be sent, all these things can be worked out in your activities. And what are these activities? This will help you to keep the track of your customers' communication that we have. So again, this is something that you would be able to see in the application. So let's say, for example, if we have a particular customer, there is a particular timeline that gets created. Now in the timeline, what exactly happens? In the timeline, all your activities are displayed. Now, when an activities are displayed, let's say, for example, if there was any ownership changes that was made, or let's say if there was a phone call due, or if there was a phone call made, or if there was any changes that has been made, all these things you would be able to see in your timeline, wherein if, let's say, for example, I'm the one who has worked on it last, and there's another person who would want to see what is exactly happening with this particular customer. So if he wants to read through any of the notes, or if he wants to see what was the last step that was done, he will be able to quickly go through the timeline and he will be able to understand that what are the different things that was done on this particular application and how it needs to be worked out over here. Then again, as I said, that we have different data sources. So let's say we are talking about the migration, wherein we have all the information in the Excel. So there is an Excel integration as well, wherein you'll be able to have the data imported or exported to Excel, whichever way that you want over here. So here you have these integration options as well. There are many integration options, but these are some of the integration options that we are actually talking about. So if you have any information in your Excel, you'll be able to import that particular information, you'll be able to make those changes, and you'll be able to add it to your Dynamics CRM application. So let's say, as I'm saying, you have like 10,000 contacts, okay, that you don't want to miss out, basically just for the migration purpose, right? Nobody would want to actually do that, hardened customers, right? So in that case, if you have that particular information in an Excel format, you will be able to directly import system, and that's it. You'll be able to make the changes and have them in your database as well. Then we have Teams integration also. Okay. Now, normally what happens is we have our credentials for the team, and there is a Teams, there is a standalone application that is there for Teams, right? So we go on to the Teams meeting right now. Also, you have joined it through a Teams meeting. So there is a Teams meeting that is there. But what if in your Dynamics CRM application only you have the feature of, you know, integrating your Teams? So then you don't have to actually change the pages, right? You will be able to see the customer's interactions or anybody's interactions that is there, or any chats that is there. So let's say if you want to get a hold of any of the customers through Teams. So you're dealing with them and you see them online with the help of this particular integration and the technology that is there, you'll be able to directly communicate with that particular customer. Okay. And you'll be able to resolve their issue. So if there's, again, we don't have to talk about the features that we have in Teams, you know, in terms of sharing the screen and showing us what the issue is, and all these things can be done over here because we have the Teams integration options also available over here. Then we have Outlook integration also that we will be able to work with. So again, if we have, let's say we want to send out a particular email, or if we want to know some information about our customers, so we will be getting some emails. So with the help of you configuring your mailbox, and you will be able to use your Outlook through the Dynamics 365 add-in as well. People, if you have worked on it before this particular application, there was also another Viva Sales, also kind of an add-in that was there, which you were able to use it in your Outlook. Similarly, here you will be able to have your Outlook integration also done over here. Again, we have a lot of other things on to the aspect of this, like there is OneDrive integration, there is SharePoint integration, and there are many other things that you can actually do with this particular application. Now, as we have worked out on the integration of this particular application, and we have read about the application, that is the Canvas application or the model-driven application, let me just give you a quick heads up or a quick tour of this particular application and show it to you how this application actually works and what is the navigation of this particular application that we are talking about. So I will be using the application. Now see, there are two aspects of this particular application. One is that you have a particular customization of the application. One is you already have the application. Okay. So normally, if you are not into the customization, there will be a particular link, okay, that you would be getting. So let's say now I am there on the Power Platform Admin Center. So in the Power Platform Admin Center, there is an environment that gets created. So environment is what? It is a container of all the application that is there. So you can have an environment based on, you know, it would be either a production environment, it would be either a sandbox environment, a trial environment. All these things would be created in your particular environment. So let's say, for example, we are working on any of the environment that is there. And let's say we are saying, so here there might be a lot of people who would be just having a particular URL. Once they click on the URL, their application actually opens up over here. Now, if you see, we are there on the Sales Hub application out here. So here, let's say, for example, if you have more info, like more application that you are using. So here, if you have the access to them, you'll be able to change the tile. And from here, you'll be able to switch between the application. Let's say if you want to go on to Customer Service Hub, or let's say if you want to go on to Field Service, if you have the access to them, you will be able to switch between the application that is there. Okay. And now this is exactly the front end wherein the out of the box features are available. Like if you see, you have the customers, you have the contacts, you have the social profiles, all these are there. And this is an area button that you have over here wherein you'll be able to work with them. Similarly, here's if you see, it says work smarter with AI, you have a capability of Copilot on the application. Now we all know with the help of Copilot, we will be able to work with the natural language and we'll be able to get our issues resolved. Now here it says if you want to write an email. So if there is an email response that if you want to send, we will be able to have an email response with the help of the AI. The only thing is we have to tell them the content, what is it that we are looking for, right? So this is basically your application. Now this application that we look over here, this is a model-driven application, right? This is a model-driven application. But right now, let's say, for example, I am looking out for, there are a lot of tables out here, okay? So let's say if there are some of the fields that I don't need it, okay? Or maybe I am a company who actually deals with only accounts, okay? Who do not need any contacts. Or let's say we are an organization who do not have any intervention of social profiles that we use, or let's say we don't want dashboards. How will you remove it? Now, these are some of the out of the box features that has been given.
But I have said that, you know, this application is highly customizable. That is where you use your Power Apps portal over here. So in your Power Apps, that is make.powerapps.com, in the Power Apps portal, basically what you will be able to do, you'll be able to create your application. Okay. So if you see you want to create, you'll be able to create a blank app. You want to create using Dataverse, SharePoint, Excel, you'll be able to create your application. If you want to create them from blank, you'll be able to create them from blank as well. Similarly, let's say, for example, you have the application already created, but then you are saying that these are some of the out of the box tables which are given, but then you are saying I need to add more tables over here, or let's say in the accounts table, right, I need to add more columns. So the columns that there are, maybe you need to add more columns onto this, or maybe the out of the box feature have missed out on some of the other columns that is there. So here you will be able to add your columns as well. And let's say, for example, you are saying that you want to build a relationship between the tables, you'll be able to build a relationship as well. Let's say you want to change the form type, so you'll be able to change the form types as well. Let's say, for example, you want to change any of the business rules on this particular application, or let's say you want to change any business process flow that is there. All these things you will be able to do in this particular Power Apps portal that you have. You'll be able to create solutions, you'll be able to create flows, you'll be able to create the applications from a blank canvas, or you will be able to create an application using your Copilot as well. So based on your Copilot, you will be able to create the application as well. So all these things can be done, and much more can be done. See, it says start with Copilot. So if I just say Copilot over here, and let's say I will just give him an instruction, I'll say create a canvas app. Let's see over here if it can create a particular canvas application for us. See, it has given us some information. So if I say create app, that's it. We are creating an app for you. So you see, it is that easy that you can actually create an application directly through your Power Apps portal over here, whether it be model-driven application, whether it be a canvas application. So when you create the application, if you want to use the application the way it is, if you want, you'll be able to use it. If you want to add more information onto this application, like you want to add some more data, you want to change the logo, you want to change the page type, you want to change anything into the properties or anything, or if you want to add more data onto this, once the app gets created for you, you will be able to make those changes in the application that is available. Again, as I'm saying, there is a lot that we can do in this particular application. And as I said, that once we try to know about this application, we will be able to see it and understand it in a better way. Okay. So this is all about your Power Apps portal that is there. So sorry, people, just give me one quick moment. Yeah. So if you have any questions, and if you want to know more about it, now see here, we have some information. Let me just share that also with you. Give me one quick moment here. Okay. So now see, when we talk about this, this is just an introduction that we have given about the CRM application and about the Power Platform. But let's say, for example, you want to know more about this. You want to get a particular training, and you know, you are looking for a career change. You want to upgrade yourself, or maybe you have a fundamental idea how things work, but you want to actually have an upgradation done. So we are the people who would actually help you. Okay, so we have a database of more than 300 plus world-class trainers who are actually certified in various skills that is there. We have flexible dates and timings as well. And there is a possibility of a one-on-one advantage also. When I say one-on-one, basically there's a lot of time when, you know, we have people who do not enjoy, or maybe, you know, who do not like the, who like to speak one-on-one so that, you know, they can get most out of it. And in a group session, it's, you know, if one question has been asked, the other one gets hesitant out there. So, you know, that is also something that we offer over here. We have a 4-hour session. So normally these batches that we take are, you know, 8 hours
batch that we say. But let's say, for example, we are into the commercial industry at the moment. Professionally, we all are actually working and then upgrading, right? So if we have like a 9-to-5 job that we have, for us to go again with the 8 hours batch would be something that, you know, we'd have to take a day off or maybe, you know, 2 days off and then, you know, attend to this particular training. Might as well, you can have flexible timings. You can have 4 hour sessions. You can have destination training as well, wherein, you know, you can fly me a trainer, wherein a trainer would come over to your place and train your people. So all these things would be available that you want. So whatever is required, we will be able to offer it to you. And the best part is here, you'll be able to not only grow, but develop something new as in the career. Right now, see, we are all in this particular era wherein, you know, the upgrades and the certifications and the technology that, you know, right now there's a lot of things that's going on. Right. So we have to be working hand in hand and we need to actually grow with the technology that is there. So if at all we have any things, we will be there to help you out here. So right now we are looking for any, if you have any questions, feel free to ask. We are available out here. And that's it from my end. Thank you all for joining in. And it was really a great time that I was able to impart a few of the introduction, I would say, or basically, you know, just covering up some things on this particular topic that is Power Apps and Power Apps with the CRM technology that we have. So thank you all for joining. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, the question and answer session is open for us. Thank you.
So Razia has asked a question. How can I set the security permission in this? So basically, security permission, if you want, so for that, you need to actually go on to there are two ways. Either from the application, you can go on to the advanced settings. And from the advanced settings, you can go on to your security roles, or else you can go on to the Power Platform Admin Center. And from there, you will be able to go on to your security roles or say the security permissions there is, wherein you will be able to look at the particular role and you will be able to offer it to them. Sumit Kumar's question has been answered. Yes. In the chat, we have the form available. We'll be able to get it. Another question. Thanks. Thank you very much for joining in. Thank you very much. So basically, we can actually create trials account. Okay, trial account. You'll be able to create your trial account through trials.dynamics.com. Okay, so you can go on to trials.dynamics.com and from there, you'll be able to create your trial account. And from there, you can actually have a practice done as well, right? So yes, you will be able to create your trial accounts and you'll be able to practice it. And there is a lot of GitHub wherein there are some tasks also that has been given to you wherein you will be able to access them as well. So you need Nicholas, please share your the link once again. I think people have not got it, so yes, the link would be shared with you all. So thank you all for joining in. And you all have a great day. If you have any questions, I'm still here for 3 more minutes. And if anybody else is there, please, thank you very much for joining. It was really a pleasure. And you all have a great day ahead. Bye-bye.
Thank you for that lovely session, Shahid. It was lovely to have you. And thank you, everyone, for joining. Kindly do fill in your attendance sheets for your webinar certificates. I hope to see you soon in the upcoming webinars. Bye-bye, everyone. Bye-bye, Shahid.
Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.
Yeah, I could see a few questions regarding the attendance. So after you fill the attendance sheet, there will be a link or say a mail will be shared from our side in which you'll receive the login portal details from of our portal. So you have to log into that portal and download your certificates. I'll repeat, after you fill the attendance sheet, which I've shared in the chat, I'll be sharing that again. Kindly fill in the attendance sheet, and after you fill the attendance sheet, you'll receive a mail from our side which contains the login portal details of our portal. So you have to log in into our portal and download your webinar certificates. I hope it is clear for everyone. Thank you. Hope to see you soon in the upcoming webinars. Okay, Shahid. Bye-bye. Take care, everyone.